Hello students, welcome to the English class. Today we will be discussing another new chapter, chapter 4 from Vistas, The Enemy, written by Pearl S. Buck. For the recent past few days, I have been giving you some of the video clips from the YouTube where you must have already know the come to know about the story. So in this presentation, basically I will be discussing the theme of the story. So let's start. The content of the story is that first we will be knowing about the author, then we will see the background of the story, the setting of the story, and then the theme of the story. Pearl S. Buck is a very famous and renowned modern writer. Though an American, her writings mainly deal about Chinese and Japanese, that is the eastern countries of the world. Pearl S. Buck was a best-selling and Nobel Prize-winning author. Her classic novel, The Good Earth, was written in 1931, was awarded a Pulitzer Prize and William Dean Howells Medal. Born in Hillsboro, West Virginia, Buck was the daughter of missionaries and spent much of the first half of her life in China, where many of her books are set. In 1934, civil unrest in China forced Buck back to the United States. Throughout her life, she worked in support of civil and women's rights and established Welcome House, the first international interracial adoption agency. In addition to her highly acclaimed novels, Buck wrote two memoirs and biographies of both of her parents. For her body of work, Buck was awarded the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1938, the first American woman to have done so. She died in Vermont. The background of the story is Second World War. We know that in the Second World War, America did not join the war initially. In 1941, Japan hurled bombs in Pearl Harbor in America, which had forced America to join the Second World War. And then we know what the impact was. With this Pearl Harbor attack, America had taken the revenge, and in 1946, they dropped bomb in Japan, in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So in the Second World War, we find that America and Japan, they were two hostile countries, where Japan was with the side of Germany and Italy, and America was by the side of Britain, isn't it? So the story takes place on a coastal town of Japan in the year 1941, when Japan attacked Pearl Harbor. A war was going on between America and Japan. Japanese were hostile to the Americans and ready to kill any American found in their soil. So in this story also we will find that how America and Japan, how this American and Japanese hostility has instilled among the common people also. There are various themes in Enemy. Okay, there are shades of themes in Enemy. We will discuss all the themes separately. First, we will see the theme of racism. Now, you know this racism is very much highlighted in this story. It is reflected in the story in several ways. When Sadao recalls how he met Hannah, he remembers that he didn't become serious with her until he was sure that she had been pure in her race. Now that is very interesting that we know Sadao. We have already come to know that who is Sadao and Hannah, isn't it? Sadao is Dr. Sadao, the renowned Japanese doctor who was not sent to the war front just because he is a renowned doctor and the general requires him, and Hannah is his wife. Now Sadao and Hannah both were in America for their education, where they met each other, and Sadao and Hannah, they fell in love with each other for the first time, at the first look itself. But Sadao would not marry Hannah. The main reason is that he wanted to make sure that Hannah is pure in her blood, a pure Japanese. Now in America it can happen that there are interracial marriages, so either of the parents can be an American or a Japanese. Okay, so Sadao wanted to know that Hannah's both parents are Japanese, because if that is not confirmed, then Sadao's father, who is very very what we can say purely Japanese in heart, would not allow Sadao to marry Hannah. Okay, because otherwise his father wouldn't have approved. You may refuse to touch the American, let alone wash him before the operation. And when he left, she cleaned the guest room thoroughly to get the white man's smell out of it. Yumi, the maid servant in Sadao and Hana's house, looking after the children of them. Yumi is also very much prejudiced. Okay, she also hates the American. She would not touch the American till the American was there in the house. And when the American left the house, she washed the room and cleaned the room so thoroughly that she said that there should not even be the smell of the American in the room. Sadao had strong feelings about white people. He thinks to himself that they are repulsive and that it was a relief to be openly at war with them at last. He also believed that Americans were full of prejudice and it had been bitter to live in it, knowing himself their superior. Now, this theme is very much interrelated to the next theme also that we are going to discuss. This feeling that I am superior to you, okay, racism, when do the feeling of racism comes to one? When I feel that I am superior to you, okay? When these kind of feelings develop among each and every human being, then racism will automatically come up, right? So Sadao also feels that as a Japanese, he is much superior than the American. And the Americans, of course, feel that they, being American, they are much superior to this Japanese. Now, as I was saying, the feeling of racism where superior and inferiority, these things happen, that comes under the conflict between East and West. The Eastern countries, they always think that the Western countries and their cultures are degenerated cultures. Okay, so they always consider the Western countries to be inferior to them. And the Western countries think that the Eastern countries are underdeveloped, they are not that much developed or not that educated like them. So they are inferior to them. So this inferior and superior feelings that happens brings about this conflict between East and West. When we are told about Sadao's father, we see that Sadao's father's room has no Western furniture. There are mats on the floor and wall cupboards with bedding. This description reinforces the importance of Sadao's father of Japanese culture and tradition. It suggests a complete rejection of Western culture, reinforcing the idea of cultural conflict between East and West. So we find that Sadao's father, who is very much Japanese by his heart, rejects anything which is Western, okay, which is American. So therefore he has never slept in an American bed or in any kind of bed. There, you know, Japanese house, you must have got some little bit of idea that they spread mats or bed sheets on the floor and they sleep over there, okay. They don't use chairs and tables for their eating. They tuck their legs under this mat and they sit down on the ground and then they have their food very silently. They have some peculiar Japanese ideas and traditions. With some of the Japanese, they follow very strictly, though we know that nowadays the Japanese, modern Japanese, they might not be following this, but those who are traditional Japanese, they follow this culture. So Sadao's father was pure Japanese. He would reject anything that was Western. Hana and Sadao were different from other Japanese because they have been exposed to Western culture and so are more open-minded and tolerant. They live a good life which combines both traditional values and modern ideas. Because they are well-educated and aware, they believe they also have a duty to humanity in addition to their duty to Japan. Okay, so Sadao and Hana, they are not like Sadao's father. They are little bit modern because they are Western educated, but still they are very much loyal towards their country. They can be told to be a true patriot. Sadao and Hana are both well educated and acquired some of that education in the USA. Therefore, they possess a great deal of knowledge of the world beyond Japan and particularly about Americans and their culture. Furthermore, Sadao is a surgeon and took an oath to save lives, which he takes very seriously. As a result, his loyalty to his country isn't the only driving force in his life. The general is also an educated man who studied at Princeton University in the USA, and this is perhaps why he can understand Sadao's big dilemma. As a general, his loyalty to his country is unquestionable. Here there is a thing that whether general was really loyal to his country or was quite selfish, we will be discussing about the character of the general while we will be explaining the chapter line by line. Sadao and Hana, they are since they are Western educated, so they are little bit liberal, okay, but one thing is sure, their loyalty or their patriotism towards their country is completely unquestionable. They are very loyal. When they wanted to treat when they say that they have to treat the Americans by their heart, they never wanted to, but because Sadao was a doctor, he had taken the oath that as a doctor, whether it is a friend or enemy in front of him, he has to save the life. So therefore, he could not reject the American's surgery or the American's treatment. But he never liked the American. As an American, he never liked him in his house. The servants are simple, uneducated people. As servants, they aren't trained to think for themselves, but to obey orders. However, we see that their loyalty to their country surpasses their loyalty to their masters. Their knowledge of the world is limited, so they can't begin to understand the dilemma that Sadao and Hana are facing. Okay, now the servants, they're uneducated. They have lived in Japan all their life. They doesn't know about the Western culture or American, all those etiquettes or those education. So when they find the American in the house, they were very repulsive. They rejected to serve the American and even left the house. And they returned back to the house only when the American was gone away from Sadao's house. Okay. And in fact, they could not even understand their master, Sadao and Hana, why they are treating this American. They could not understand. So that was quite expected from them. So there we find the conflict of the East and West in this, in the attitude of the servant also. The last theme is war and its impact. We know that whenever there has been a war, there is some, what we can say, the impact is very deeply found among the common people also. Not only the political, or it's only the political head will, which will suffer the impact of the war. It's not so, but common people also faces the same impact. Now, when there is a war, okay, like when Japan and America was on war, though it was completely a political war where only the political leaders were deciding where the soldiers are going to go or whom they will be warring against, but the common people also had the same feeling. This hatred between the countries, or this hatred amongst the people, could be seen even among the common people. The story takes place during World War II. From the story, we can understand that Japan was a totalitarian, means a dictatorial state in which rulers dealt harshly with those who opposed them. We know in the Second World War, Japan, Germany, and Italy, these three countries were dictatorial countries. They were having dictators who were ruling the country as only a one ruler policy. Okay, so Japan was also a totalitarian country, and it would not accept any of its countrymen showing sympathy towards its enemy country. People could be informed on, arrested, and condemned to death. When you have read Annie Frank, those who are from CBSE in class 10, when you have read Annie Frank, you must have read that how Germany's dictatorial regime had impacted or affected the common people's life. Okay, anyone who was against the country, whom the country has decided considering to be their enemy, were immediately informed to the government, and how the this ruling party would inflict any kind of tortures among those people. Same thing is happened over here also. When Sadao brought the American in the house, everyone was worried that if somehow the news goes to the ruling party or to the governor of the, or the general of the country, that there is an American in the Sadao's house undergoing treatment, then that would be a real cause of danger. Sadao could be imprisoned, Sadao could be hanged also. An atmosphere of fear and mistrust prevailed. Hana and Sadao mistrust the servants. Sadao and the general mistrust each other. So that is the impact of the war, where you cannot even trust even your fellow beings also. The Japanese are mistrusting each other. So that is a very cruel impact among the people. Means we are not only hating our enemy countries, but we are even not believing our own countrymen during the war time. From what Tom says to Sadao, we can infer that Tom thinks most Japanese are cruel and inhuman, unlike Sadao. If I hadn't met a Jap like you, well, I wouldn't be alive today. I know that. The Japanese are aggressive and militaristic, as he says. I suggest if all the Japs were like you, there wouldn't have been a war. So here again, we find some kind of racial prejudices is also there. Conflict between East and West is also there. And of course, the impact of the war is also there. Tom does not like Sadao. Sadao does not like Tom. But both of them are under each other. Means Tom needs the help of Sadao, and Sadao, being a doctor, cannot reject Tom. So what kind of human conflict goes on here? Okay, means Tom says that all the Japanese are cruel except Sadao. Is it possible? If all the Japanese are cruel, Sadao would also have been cruel. So this is the general idea we develop, okay, about a country against whom which we are at war. Universal human values take precedence over narrow sectarian considerations like racism, nationalism, chauvinism. So of course human values are there, okay. Sometimes human values does not work, like suppose in the case of say this the servants, okay. The human values did not work, okay. They did not like the American and they wanted that this American should move out from the house, and they could not even understand that why Sadao and Hana is treating the American so nicely or serving the American. So of course here the human values does not work, but regarding Sadao and Hana, human values work, okay. The humanitarian quality of Sadao had overwhelmed him, okay. It had taken precedence over the narrow sectarian consideration, narrow feelings like patriotism, which does not have any other outlet, okay. So like racism, nationalism, chauvinism, okay, these things are important in life, but more important is of course humanity, the feeling of humanity, the feeling of human values. The bond uniting all human beings transcends the difference between us, right? So of course this human bonding or the human values should be there. This is also one thing which Perlis Buck has very nicely highlighted in the story, is that what should we take more important, national feeling or human values? And here we find of course in Dr. Sadao's story that human values are more respected than national feelings. Well students, I hope you have understood the themes of the story, okay. So in my next presentation, in my next video, I will be discussing or I will be explaining the story line by line. So if you have the text in my next video, please open the text and we will be going through the story line by line. Thank you all.